Jesus Ben Joseph of the House of Panther.
Maybe you might want to question me on that.
Was a black man, and we have empirical evidence to that fact. We're not saying it because we would like it to be so, because it makes us feel good to think that. It is a historical fact that you can't get around.
Wow! Yes, brothers and sisters, huh? It's time for the liberation of your mind now, huh? This is what they got locked up in the museum in England right now today, showing the true African Jesus right here, where the Europeans copied from this one to make their version of it right here. Even Reverend Bar Shango said that Jesus was from the tribe of the Black Panthers. I noticed that there was a Black Panther down by his legs. Huh? Well, I like how y'all did that lean at the same time.
The ancient chemists and priests who were also scientists. You all know where ancient chemist is, don't you? In case somebody don't know, please tell us where it is. And where is Egypt? I want to make sure it's not in the Middle East somewhere. These priests practice what they call, listen brother, they practice what they call Maya Suna. Because they said in order for a man to know God, he must first intimately know woman. Contrary to this thing about celibate priests, they can't know nothing. Because if you ain't hooked up with the female energy, you don't know nothing. And this is why they said that. There was a scientific reason for it. When the young man was trained in manhood training, as the young woman was trained, and the young man was trained that when he had the privilege of going back to be born again, to go to heaven, as Dr. Yusuf Ben Jotana said, the only heaven he ever knew was the vagina of the black woman. And that is the only heaven I have ever known. And believe me, I love being born again. Because in Africa there was a mother god before there was a father god. What did I say? There was a mother god before there was a father god. And we're going to deal with that as we go on.
Take one.